TOM LYNCH, and welcome to my studio where I want to share with you a unique device that I use when creating compositions. Now, composition, if you haven't heard, let me tell you, most of us as professional artists, composition is the number one item. Those shapes, that proportion, that arrangement, if it's not working with a line drawing, it's not going to work when you make it into color. You might be familiar with a great little device, where it creates a window and we look outdoors and we get a proportion, or sometimes even from a photograph, we get an idea of how much we want to bracket or what portion of the landscape we want to save and make into a painting. Worked great for me for many years, but I always had trouble transferring this idea to my final sketch. By the time I put my hand down, did some sketching, put this back up, had to rearrange where was I, what did I pick as the proportions. That always caused me a little bit of a trouble when I was making a composition. Next, when I had the idea, getting that to my paper with the same arrangement. Although once in a while, I wanted to change the arrangement. So I might have done a side preliminary sketch, and then I'm drawing and erasing and drawing and erasing where I wanted to make something a little larger or a little smaller. Again, that little blueprint trying to get an idea of a good composition. Well, I have made things a little easier, and I think you might like this particular item that I use. I created a homemade device, and eventually when I showed it to one of my friends at Gorilla Painter, they said, hey, I bet there's a lot of other artists that would like to use this same idea as well. So here is what we've come up with. I'll give you a little description and I'll take you and show you using a photograph. Mainly I brought this for outdoor plein air painting, but now I'm using it indoors just as much. So it's a piece of lucite or plastic, and there are three different sheets. The idea being, with a dry erase pen, I can begin getting my idea of that same proportion arrangement that I might want to have. And so I can draw on this, just take my finger, instead of having to erase and doing this in pencil, I could take and use just this dry erase and get an idea of what I wanted. But on occasion, that item in the foreground, I might want it to be larger. So I would bring this closer to me, and then I could experiment with, no, it's a little too large, a little farther away. So I could get an experiment with the idea of the proportion and the arrangements with having this particular. Then all I would have to do is slide in the white sheet, and then I could see my design, see my arrangement, and make some fine-tuning adjustments. Then solving another problem, taking and bringing in a grid. So there's a clear plastic sheet that has a grid to it, and so that I could bring in this clear plastic grid, and now it would take my idea and grid it so that I could transfer what I'm looking at, the arrangement that I created that I feel now works a little bit better. There's always some fine tuning. I might want to look over to this side and take that rock grouping, and then over there and take those trees. So I am composing. Composition means composing, putting the best of these ideas together. Then I would bring the grid into place. So now I could look at this and transfer with a good proportion. I didn't have that one item too small or end up with that house right in the middle. Even though I thought I had a good idea, I still can make some mistakes, and I'm not erasing. So us watercolor artists, erasing on that watercolor paper or watercolor canvas, don't want to mess up the surface with some pencil marks and erasures again and again. So that is what has helped me with my composition, where I could rearrange things. There's another little bonus you get, a red filter. So now I can take a look at the scene, be it a photograph that I have in front of me, or the actual scene before me if I'm painting plein air, and I can get a value separation, a nice feeling. Oh, I thought the house was the lightest item in the painting. It was the rocks in the sky. They were lighter than the actual house. So I had some values to be able to follow and work with. So there's a quick little explanation. Let me bring you in closer. I'll have you look over my shoulder using a photograph for the moment where I can take and use the composition. Here's an example. I have two or three different pictures. I didn't have an example of the Rialto Bridge in the right spot. And so now I could bring in a photograph. Well, let's just do it. So come on, look over my shoulder, take a look up close, and get an idea where this handy little composition tool, whether you're plein air or in the studio, can help you a lot. All right, I've begun my sketch, and let me pull away the white sheet so that you can see. So here was an image of Venice. And I wanted to create a painting, but everything wasn't quite as interesting, I thought, as it could be. So I began with hovering this over my photograph and just lightly blocking in. Let me have you see that again. So lightly blocking in the image. But what was in the foreground, I wanted it to be a little bit larger, so I would bring this a little closer. So now I could work at seeing right through and onto my image. I wanted to raise that closer so that this building and the umbrellas and the boats were a little bit larger. But in the photograph, I didn't like having another continuation of buildings in the background. Had I moved over a little bit or been out on a boat, I might have seen the Rialto Bridge. So I have another photograph of the Rialto, and how close I am makes the image get smaller. And so now I could get an idea of adding, you know, the Rialto Bridge in the background, just a rough idea, and adding some buildings in the background as well by hovering it over. If I want it smaller, I bring this closer to me while I'm looking through it, seeing the actual Rialto Bridge in the background. Oops, I decided to make it even smaller yet, and I noticed there's a bit of an angle to the Rialto Bridge, and so I was able to change that proportion, make these buildings smaller. So see how I can make adjustments so easily by erasing away. And last but not least, a gondolier. So do I want a giant one? Hold it close. Did I want a very small one? Bring it further back. And now I could add. So I'm able to look right through this to the actual scene, either from a photograph or when I'm working live. When I want to do some fine tuning with this, I can now bring in this white sheet, and so I don't need the photograph anymore, just have it to the side. And then when it comes time to now transfer this to my actual watercolor paper, I can bring in the grid, and so I can see with this grid underneath that according to that line, the first mark in, I would have had a mark on my watercolor paper with a pencil line. I can see where the proportions are, where the series of buildings in front end, where the buildings in back are, or maybe I want to take out the Rialto and put in across from St. Marco Square the cathedrals. And so I could experiment with that idea. So hopefully now you can get an idea working from photographs. So I put several photographs on one sheet there. And I wanted a gondolier. I wanted the Rialto. I wanted some of these particular buildings. I wanted that one larger. And how easy it is for me to take and work out this composition, looking right through this piece of plastic at the actual photograph. And when it comes time to modify it, I put that clear piece of sheet of paper in, that clear film in, and now I can fine-tune my design. Last but not least, looking through the red filter, and I can see the value tones. So I can see really what tone is this in relationship to considerably lighter, and actually the water is even lighter than that. So I can start thinking about my value plan by looking through the red filter. Doesn't this give you an easy way to develop a composition, especially when you're using different images to make the best that this scene could possibly be of Venice?
Well, if I made that look too easy, it really was. And this was the whole idea of my creating this for myself. And now you're able to get one too. I'm sure you have a lot of photographs, like I have, of great parts, like the city of Venice. And I wanted to put some of them together. Wasn't sure about adding the figure, adding the gondolier, and now with my little secret plein air tool, which is really a composition tool for indoors or outdoors, you can experiment quickly with enlarging something for the foreground to exaggerate the feeling of depth, or adding something like I did the Rialto Bridge. Only you and I know the secret that where I was standing couldn't quite see it. But our job is to tell a story. And so I wanted to tell a story of the beauty of Venice and some of the iconic landmarks. So I hope my little composition tool will help you as much as it has helped me creating a nice arrangement. A quick rough draft can be done in an easy way with the grid. Once that composition is created, I can transfer it without making more mistakes. Okay, happy to share with you what I'm doing, not only in painting, but this moment in developing a composition. My thanks to the people at Gorilla Painter, Carl. He saw this in work and he says, we've got to share this with others. So now you have a chance to get one and make use of it and become a better painter from the first step. Finding a good composition. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you in class soon. Bye for now.